What's going on, everybody? This is Fishing for Silver, and yesterday we did like half of a nickel box. We did 25 rolls of a nickel box hunt, and I didn't get to film it much because my family was home, and I just didn't feel like interrupting what they were doing. But we actually found two war nickels in the first part of that box. We found a 43 and a 44. I believe they're both out of Philly. There you go. You can see the big mint mark on this one really, really good. This one, you can see it there pretty good. Let's zoom in a little bit. No, it makes it more blurry. But there is two war nickels in the first half of that box, so that's a really good box so far as war nickels go. We also found a couple Canadians, nothing old. There's a few 50s here that I'm going to keep. We found a couple 40s, and then these are 60s that are in pretty good shape. We found a few coins that are in... Ooh, that was kind of loud. We found a few coins that are in, like, pretty good shape. Like, this 2000 coin is really, really nice and just doesn't look like it's been circulated very much at all. And then we found this 64 that's in pretty good shape, and we found another like a 1990 or something. I can't remember what it was. It's an 89D, and let me find it. There we go. And it's in pretty good shape as well. So I pull out those and I check them in my book, and if they're worth something, you know, in the condition they're in. If they're not, I'll usually put them back. That's about it. I'm probably going to use this as the intro, and then you're going to see me actually open some rolls if I find anything, and you're going to get to see one of the war nickels that I recorded, but I didn't record both of them, so you're only going to get to see one of them. So there's the find so far, and we're going to get into it, and I'll loop you guys back in if I find anything else. So here we go. This is roll number 26. And right here, we've got a 1958. Well, it's not going to focus. There it goes. And it's 1958D. So, there we go. We'll add that to our 50s column. So, I was looking through the end of this roll right here, and it looks like we've got a 55 nickel. And it's a 55D. I'll have to check that because I don't remember right off the top of my head if that's any significance or anything. But I've got my coin book over here and it tells me. So let me see if I can't dig it out real quick. What was it, a 55D? Got me a new coin book here to hunt. 55D. See, the 55 is the one that's rare. I knew that there was a 55 that's rare, but it's the regular 50, the 55 Philly. The 55D is 74.5. So really, that's not that bad, 74.5 million, but it's not on the rare side. So we're going to keep hunting, and I'll get you guys back in here if we find anything. So I'm sure you can see it right there, but there's something that's not quite American there. Got a little Canadian nickel, another one. So that's three in the box so far. This is actually a really good nickel box for me so far. We got three Canadians, we got two silvers. So I'm gonna keep hunting them. I'm really excited about finishing up this box. And I just pulled out this 1998D, and I mean, it's got a little scuff on the front there, but it is absolutely beautiful. So this nickel box has been pretty good. So, in this last roll, I found a 1954, and it just so happens to be an S mint mark. Now, I've looked at this, and I don't think it's the D over S, the very popular, or not very popular, but the really expensive variety that you can get here. But this is 100% a 1954S, which there's only about 30 million of these minted. So, it's worth... In the shape it's in right now, probably a dollar, but it can be worth more than that if it's in really, really good shape. So that's a special one, and I don't actually have this in my album. So I wanted to share that, and I wanted to take a minute and zoom in on it and make sure that it wasn't the D over S version because that would have been really cool. Unfortunately, it's not, but you never know. I'm gonna get back to the hunt. So this is the very next roll after that 1954, and right here, the very first coin in the roll, and Ender was a 48D. So that's pretty cool. I didn't see it till just now when I was going through them. But I started to go through them and I just saw it. I didn't even see it when I sprawled out the roll. So that's a pretty neat find. All right. So I was hunting here and I come across a 41 out of Philadelphia. Not the worst shape. Doesn't upgrade my album or anything. But another 40's nickel for the hunt. Let's get back to it. Okay, I was hunting here and this one was flipped backwards and I didn't know that it was actually going to be that old because there's no mint mark. And it's a 1940. It's got some damage for sure. This back is pretty scratched up, scuffed up. But it's a 1940 nickel. We'll throw that up here and we'll keep on hunting. Okay, so this is the very next roll after that 1940. And I think he had a twin, a 1940. No mint mark. It's crazy. One right after the other. So I guess we're going to keep on hunting. But that was crazy. There is a really dark one here. That's like really weird looking. What's that say? I can't even read that. Holy cow, that poor thing is. It might have been a 1960. I don't know. Not a keeper, but a weird coin indeed. So we got another one here, and this one's actually a 48 out of Denver. So, sorry about that. A 48 out of Denver. There's only about 50 million of these minted or so. 45 million, actually, I think. So, that's a more rare nickel too. Anything under 50 million is considered more rare. So I'm gonna get back to the hunt and hopefully we find some more. So we've got another interesting find here. We've got a 1952, which was a year where they didn't make a whole bunch of nickels. Well, I dropped it. 1952, a year where they didn't make a ton of nickels, and this is really, really hard to see. But I'm pretty sure it is a D mint mark, and I'll zoom in on it and make sure. But a 52D, and it's really not in that bad of shape. The memorial bin's pretty scuffed up, but the wording and letters are all really, really nice on it. So we're gonna keep hunting. We're down, that's the last roll right there. We're on the second to last roll. So we're almost done, sadly. But we'll have more hunts coming soon, I'm sure. Not a bad hunt at all. We've went through this whole nickel thing. We've got a whole big tub of nickels here. Not a bad hunt at all. We found two silver war nickels. So there's those guys. We found a couple nickels that are on the more rare side. So like the 30 million minted or so. We've got a stack here. These are all the 50s. This is a stack of 40s. This is some 60s to check for the album. Then I pulled some of these over here. These are just album checking coins. There's a metal detecting. It looks like a metal detector find here. I'm going to throw it in my metal detecting box. And then a couple toned coins there that are okay. That's really about it. I'm going to check these against the album. And I think this will be the end of the video. We've got some new coins for our collection here. So that's going to be about it. This is Fishing with Silver. And we'll see you guys in the next video. Peace out. What's going on? This is Fishing for Silver YouTube channel, and I got us a box of nickels here to hunt and look through today. And I took out one roll and opened it up, and I got a little bit of a surprise because that's a 1943 Philadelphia war nickel in the very first roll. Wasn't even planning on recording this, but I opened up the very first roll and got a war nickel, so I had to include that in the video.